Last one game of the season, not very much to play for, just plenty to fucking celebrate. Arsenal match preview. Welcome back to another video on the channel, Newcastle fans. If you are new to Black and White Banter, make sure you drop down, give us a like, give us a subscribe, and make sure you get us on Facebook and Instagram as well. Things are booming on there at the moment. Here we are, last home game of the season. Won't be doing many of these match previews for quite a long time, with unfortunately the summer on the horizon, no football. I think Saturday just gone was the first of 12 Saturdays without Premier League football. That just sounds fucking horrendous. No tournaments to even look forward to like we had last summer because of this stupid Winter World Cup. But hey, here we are, last game of the season in what is probably going to feel like a bit of a celebration. In previous years, that lap of honour that the players have done at the last home game around the pitch to say thanks to the fans hasn't really brought that many people to stay behind. I think you'll probably see almost a full stadium stay behind on Monday night to clap off. Anyhow, the owners, who I've got no doubt will probably be on the pitch, they'll get involved because they get involved with everything that the football club does at the moment. And let's give them players the loudest cheers we possibly can for what they have managed to achieve in, what, 5 months? 5 short months? I think before I touch on the Arsenal game, can I just say the fact that Eddie Howe is being nominated for Premier League Manager of the Season is absolutely phenomenal. And I really, really want the bloke to win. I totally understand Jurgen Klopp. A lot of people are backing him. I think he's higher on the percentages because he's potentially going to win the Carabao, the FA Cup and even the Champions League as well. I get that argument, but what Eddie Howe has done has never been done before in history, turning around a football team that had won 0 football matches going into December to now even be getting in the top 10 at one point, even having European football 2 or 3 weeks ago talked about with almost the same crop of players, give or take a couple that have played most games since January, is just absolutely incredible. And you know, no matter what Eddie Howe does as Newcastle manager moving forward, I will always hold the man in the highest regard because of what he achieved with this football club. And who knows, I think we can only get better and I want Eddie Howe at the helm long term based off what I've seen so far. So I just wanted to quickly mention that. So Arsenal, now our season is ending very interestingly and I'm quite happy about it because we've got nothing to play for, but we have a say in so many things, which just adds, sprinkles that little bit of spice on our remaining fixtures. So we had Liverpool going for the title, ran them for the money. We had Manchester City, less said about that game, the fucking better. But no, we had nothing to play for, so it wasn't as much of a worry to see us get battered, because we always get battered at Man City. But now we've got Arsenal chasing that Champions League fourth spot. I think if Arsenal win on Monday, it's in their hands going into the last game by 1 point. So every Tottenham fan is a Newcastle fan on Monday night and we have a say. So the pressure's on them and I think that's only good for us because St.James Park on Monday night is going to be absolutely rocking. War flags is going to be the biggest ever display they've done. I think they've been in the stadium about 4 days early putting the flags out. Absolutely brilliant work from everybody involved in that and I cannot wait to get in there and soak up this amazing atmosphere that we finally got back at St.James Park for the first time in what feels like my lifetime supporting Newcastle since the Bobby Robson days for me. You know, Benitez days were good, but this feeling of unity because Mike Ashley is gone is just incredible. And we're waving goodbye to that now for a couple of months on Monday. And that's why Under the Lights, which is always a better atmosphere, night games, is going to be fantastic. And I think we are going to be well up for this one. Man City, we weren't at the races. Liverpool, we were a bit flat. I think last home game of the season is really, really going to spur the players on by what they hear in the stands. And Arsenal, the pressure is on them. And if there's one team in this league that we know is getting more and more known for being bottle jobs in high pressure moments, it is this Arsenal team of recent years. And yeah, we've got now to play for, but everything again in terms of a win against a team that we have got an awful record against. Whether it's at the Emirates or St. James, as Arsenal have absolutely run us ragged the last 4 or 5 years. Really, really struggle. I think it's been 5 games since we've even scored against them, I think I heard on Sky Sports this morning. So, with regards to teams, I don't think Eddie Howe is going to change that much. I don't want him to tinker. I really hope he doesn't. There's no reason to. I think he will be playing the players that he sees as his core team going at the end of the season. So defensively, I wouldn't change very much. But Kieran Trippier, if he's fit, which I think he is after he played at Man City, he needs to come in. So I do believe that Kieran Trippier will be back in action tomorrow, which is going to give us an added boost with set pieces, an added boost defensively, and it's going to be great for us fans to finish our season by watching what I think is one of the best defenders we've signed since, one of the best I've seen in the short time he's played for us since Johnny Woodgate, in terms of leadership, defensive quality, and even threat going forward is brilliant as well. We saw it against Man City in the short time he was on the pitch. So I think he'll be back. I think Callum Wilson's going to get a start as well. So for me, those would be the only two changes I would make. I think Alan Saint-Maximin in midfield needs to offer us a little bit more. I think Monday is a good opportunity in front of a packed St.James' Park against Arsenal, who aren't great defensively. I think under Mikel Arteta, I really can't really figure Arsenal out. Are they a good side? Do they deserve to? I don't know what their ambitions are. They're a weird footballing team for me. Still very struggling with an identity under the time Arteta's been there. So Saint-Maximin, I think he needs to offer us a bit more. He needs to be better with the football than what he has been the last three or four games. And he needs to get back to, yes, doing what we know he can, electrifying us in the crowd by taking on players, carrying us down the field in a team, in a match where I maybe expect Arsenal to have quite a lot of the ball. It just depends how the game starts. But yeah, I'm hoping for a good performance from Maximin, so all of this negative talk about him can start to drift away a little bit. Bruno, for me, good opportunity for him to showcase again some of his class that we know he oozes in central midfield. And with Callum Wilson, I am excited to see Bruno, who we know can pick a pass, playing with a striker who plays on the shoulder. Wilson got a chance against Man City quite quickly on. He should have probably scored. I'm looking forward to having a striker who's not as static as Chris Wood. And I think Bruno and Maximin thrive off that a little bit as well. So it's great to have Callum in. Let's just hope he stays fit. God, I know the bloke's made of glass. Apart from that, yeah, I think he'll go with Bruno. Shelby's now done for the season, so we know he's not going to be playing. So who does he go with from there? Well, we know Joe Linton's going to be in. That's a starter. Has to be in that starting lineup in central midfield, trying to pull the strings and break up their play as much as possible. For me, Willock's obviously out for the season as well, according to Eddie Howe, so he's not an option. So you'd probably assume that Longstaff's going in there. Now, obviously, Longstaff, there's contract issues going on. We don't even know whether he'll be a Newcastle player next season. Who knows on that one? But you would assume that's maybe who he's going to play there. So, again, if it is Longstaff, I'm hoping for more from him, because he hasn't really set the world alight under Eddie Howe, which is why I wouldn't be too fussed to be left, based off what I've seen since Eddie Howe's come into the football club. Geordie lad, and I love him for that, but if he's wanting guaranteed playing time, I don't think he's going to get that, because we're only going to spend in the summer. But let's just go out and enjoy it. I don't think Arsenal's a scary match compared to the Man City's and the Liverpool's we've had recent weeks. Can we create chances against Arsenal? Yes. With Callum Wilson on the field, are we more likely to take those chances? Yes. Are we better defensively with Kieran Trippier? Yes. It's just nullifying the players like Saka and some of their really, really more creative outlets from midfield. And I think you've always got a chance against Arsenal, and Arsenal are always likely to concede a goal. So I'm looking forward to Monday night. Atmosphere is going to be fantastic. It's a good chance for us to wave those players off for the amazing job that they have done. And it's the last chance in St. James's Park before the next game at the start of the 22-23 season, where who knows where we will be, what money we've spent, and what our ambitions might be by then. My God, it's a summer of excitement, and I cannot wait to start doing videos on who we link with, who we've made bids for, and it's going to happen. Let's face it, even if we don't get all the players we want, the money is going to start getting thrown, and we are going to start to climb that ladder and try to build on what Eddie Howe's already achieved. So I'm going to go for a score draw tomorrow. I think Arsenal won't bottle it and lose, but I don't think they'll get the win that they need, because it's going to be a great atmosphere and our players are going to be up for this one more than any other fixtures that we have in the last couple of games. So I'm going to go for a score draw. Like I say, if you are new to Black and White Banter, get down, like and subscribe, and get in our comments and let us know how you think the game's going to go, whether you fancy us to win, and just whether you're going to be there and what you think of the season. Last home game of the season, let us know what you think of the season so far. And hopefully, Monday night, I'll touch down for a match review on a fantastic final night at St. James's Park, where we send Arsenal packing on their Champions League hopes. How are the lads?
Newcastle.